Rose, it's Wednesday, December 10th, putting us right in the middle of the holiday season, which has gotten me thinking a lot about different holiday songs, including everyone's favorite overly repetitive song about using material possessions to acquire love, the 12 Days of Christmas. And you all know how much I love to overanalyze things, so let's take a look at the math of the 12 days of Christmas. So, as you may know, on the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day, though, they gave me two turtle doves and another partridge in another pear tree. At least, that's how I always interpreted the song. So, for the sake of fun, let's assume that after 2 days, you now have two turtle doves, two partridges, and two pear trees. If we extrapolate this out over the rest of the 12 days, you can see how quickly things actually start to add up, until after the 12 days of Christmas are over and we are left with 12 drummers drumming, 22 pipers piping, 30 lords a-leaping, 36 ladies dancing, 40 maids a-milking, 42 swans a-swimming, 42 geese a-laying, 40 golden rings, 36 calling birds, 30 French hens, 22 turtle doves, and 12 partridges in 12 separate pear trees. Oh, thank you, no, thank you. Oh, you're too much. Really, you're too much. Now, one of the first things you might notice about the data is that when graphed, it forms a parabola, with the most numerous items being those started during the middle of the time period. Why is that? Well, think of the partridge. Even though you got one every day of the 12 days of Christmas, you still only got one per day, versus, say, the geese, where you got six a day for an entire week. That quickly adds up. And even though you got 12 drummer boys in one day, that only happened once, on the last day. And hence, the parabola. So, let's take this a fun step further. I want to know how much it would cost to actually provide this specific assortment of gifts. So, the first thing we need to do is figure out the prices of all of these things. So, I researched and found the average prices of all of these objects, assuming the cost to buy the animals and objects versus the cost of the services of the people. Assuming we weren't going to be, you know, owning any humans after this. In general, a good rule to follow. But there's one alteration. With maids a-milking, they're surely going to need something to milk, and since we have 40 maids, we need 40 cows, because why wouldn't we need 40 cows? 40 cows for you! 40 cows for you! Okay, I suppose the maids a-milking are only coming 8 at a time, so we can probably get by with just 8 cows. 8 cows to you! 8 cows to— Now, if we multiply the individual prices of all the things by how many of them we have at the end of the 12 days, we reach a final expenditure of $126,290. And that's just the price to buy everything, let alone the maintenance costs. I mean, keep in mind, you now own 184 more birds than you did 2 weeks ago. That is an investment. So, in conclusion, to anyone who might be considering executing the 12 days of Christmas on a loved one, make sure that you have enough room for a great deal of leaping and dancing and enough space for 8 cows and a huge flock of birds. And Rose, we will see you on Friday.